Hey guys, I'm shooting this intro using Reolink E1 Pro. Hey there, today we are talking about Reolink camera, and this in particular model is E1 Pro, and it's pretty decent considering the price. This is around $50 or £50 on Amazon, and obviously, as usual, I'm going to list the links to this product in the description of this video. Now, this has been kindly sent to me by Reolink, and I started to wonder why, because this has excellent reviews on Amazon as it is, and it should sell as hot buns. So I'm just going to take a closer look and try to nitpick all the things that I don't like about it, and all the things are quite awesome about this camera, so I guess let's gonna get started now. But first, let me establish some sort of authority. It's not the first time I'm looking at the IP cams. I've talked about Sonoff IP cameras, which is gonna be linked somewhere in there, and also I've played with this quite cool camera from a different company, which is gonna cover later on, and Shelly Eye from Shelly. So I know a little bit about different cameras and what to expect at different price points. As this is kind of a mid-range camera, I was approaching this with certain expectations, and I'm pleased to say that actually this is pretty awesome. Let's start with setup process. Setup of this camera is super simple, as long as you remember one thing. To find the SD card and the reset button, all you have to do is just to flip the eye up, and I will expose both a reset button and SD card. Something that wasn't clear at first, but hey, I got there in the end. Now download the app and follow the instructions. You'll have no problem setting this up. And this is the first advantage in here. This camera actually supports dual band Wi-Fi, so you can use either 2.4 GHz or 5.0 GHz networks. Since it's an IP camera, so let's talk about connectivity first. And this is where this device excels truly. Apart from apps available on Android and iPhone, I've used Android in my review. There are also software, dedicated software that you can use on PC, Linux, and Apple computers, which is brilliant because not all of the cameras support that. And on top of that, Reolink was actually kind enough to include two options for cloud storage. Unfortunately, the cloud storage isn't available in UK, so I was not able to test it. But if you in an available location with a cloud storage for you, you have 7 free days of backup storage for this particular model. And also there are pricing plans which span from $3.50 to over $10, and it's $10 for $49 for the most robust plan supporting many cameras. If you don't want to pay for that, then obviously you can store footage yourself, not only on the SD card included, up to 64 gigs supported, but also there is a real-time streaming protocol, so RTSP, which you can set up with everything. So you can take a look at this and record it on a different device you want, or you just, I don't know, open VLC and enable stream, so you can stream the footage directly to your computer this way. Simple enough. It isn't a cloud enabled camera, so obviously you're going to have an access from this smart displays, providing you're gonna enable first the access on the app itself. Very clever, they do it by device. And then you'll be able to stream the footage from camera with a voice request using either Amazon Echo or Google devices with display. Unfortunately, that functionality has a latency of 15 seconds. I'm not 100% sure why, but it makes it less suitable for situations when you want to monitor a door or similar, because it will take time to open and then you'll be constantly 15 seconds behind. That's a bit disappointing, to be honest. But if you're only interested in getting that stream ready so you could take a peek at whatever camera is looking right now, then obviously that 15 seconds shouldn't really put you off, and the stream is quite good. Before I jump into software specific functions, let's talk about a video and audio features on this camera. Thanks to the 4 megapixel sensor, actually footage from this camera is very crisp. And on top of that, because it's more than 1080p as well, you can zoom in considerably using digital zoom without losing much details. So if it's a resolution you're after, I have no doubt that this camera is gonna please you. Nighttime performance, do not confuse that with nightmare performance. It's pretty decent. If you want to look particularly creepy, just turn infrared on, and that's the result inside my pitch black office. Now, nighttime performance is quite decent as well, especially indoors when the built-in infrared LEDs are strong enough to illuminate the entire room in a pitch dark conditions. I've also tested the camera outside to see how far these LEDs would go, and my back garden is about 7 meters long, and it was capable of illuminating pretty much everything in the back garden. Not too bad. There is a microphone inside and a speaker at the back. Now, speaker at the back is never a good idea, however, it's actually quite loud and it doesn't sound bad. Don't get me wrong, you're not going to be playing any tunes anytime soon from this device, but the voice was coming out clear and it was, well, perfectly understandable. Now, the microphone, however, it does require the subject to be about a meter away from the camera, otherwise you'll have to crank up the especially mobile app to the full in order to hear anything that's being spoken to the camera. Slightly disappointing, I would expect a little bit more range considering that you have a pass-through audio and you can speak or have a conversation with a person on the other side of the camera. That covers video and audio, so let's talk about interesting features. You have three different settings for quality stream, from the lowest to the highest one, but you are fully in control to what they are. You can pick the resolution, you can pick the frame rate and the bit rate as well, which means you have a control over how heavy or how big in megabytes is going to be that footage. In the best possible settings, you are looking at about 25 megabytes per minute of the footage, and considering that this device has a 64 gigabyte support for SD cards, that will give you around 40 hours of footage. It's just about enough to make it useful for without using it with external backup solution. As usual with these cameras, there are a couple of modes that you can set up. First of all, there's a strange decision where you can't really set up patrolling from the app, but you can set up full patrolling options from the Windows or Linux or Apple software. I don't know why this is not included in the app, but well, if you want patrolling, you'll have to refer back to a desktop computer or laptop computer software instead. Now, because it's an IP camera, then you have a couple of options. First of all, continuous recording, and you can set it to overlight or all footage if you run out of space. Now, nice things are that you can set different schedules for continuous recording or motion triggers because the camera is equipped with a motion trigger. Now, this motion trigger can be customized as well. You can pick different sensitivity for different times. You can also define areas in which this camera is going to trigger motion alarms. Obviously, those can be then further sent to you as a notification to your phone or sent via email. Another interesting feature is that you can actually block off certain areas from your screen with the black squares. That will increase the privacy, so if the camera is facing certain windows or areas you don't want to be present on the stream or on the recorded footage, you can simply use that editor to block them off and have your mind at rest. As awesome as it is, it unfortunately doesn't come with object tracking, so even though it will detect the motion, the camera won't be able to follow that motion around, something that is quite a big of a mission considering that it has two motors inside and it can trigger on motion. Another thing is lack of AI support, which would be interesting to have for facial recognitions and recognizing different various objects, which could be really handy. And lastly, despite having a built-in microphone, loud sounds cannot be used for trigger. I don't know why, but hey, they can't. But what you do get for your money is a pretty well-designed product that's probably gonna meet most of your expectations. So if you were looking for IP cameras and your budget is around £50 or $50 depending on the promotion, check back in the description for this link and probably some discount code that I could offer as well. Thanks so much for Reolink for sending this for a review, and if you're interested, there is an additional link for the written review and some pictures as well that you can check out in an associated article. As for now, guys, you probably know I do not have a posting schedule, but you should really, really subscribe, like, and you know how YouTube works. I'm not going to teach you that, but what I'm going to tell you that social media of your choice is available on your screen, and that's the best way to keep in touch and get notified instantly whenever there is a new upload or article, because I do both. So if you're interested, guys, and you've enjoyed this video, do let me know, and I'm gonna see you in the next video, maybe with this review. Take care. Bye.